In the Second World War, the German military needed a way to securely transmit messages to each other without worrying that their enemies could read them. This led to the adoption of a special coding machine known as the Enigma machine. The function of the Enigma machine is simple. It takes a plain text and converts it to a string of letters that means nothing at all. The transmitted messages would hence be secured with a secret code, which the Germans were confident was unbreakable. Now I shall let you in on the secret of how the Enigma machine works. What the Enigma machine does is it substitutes each individual letter with another letter. Something like what you used to do in high school, where you send a coded message to your classmate. You might have replaced each alphabet with its previous alphabet. For instance, you might have spelled banana as AZ MZ MZ. Of course, if used during the war, such a simple code would be broken in no time. An amazing feature of the Enigma machine is its ability to substitute similar letters with different letters. For instance, each E in a sentence on the screen is substituted with different alphabets. The first with a Y, the second with a P, and the third with a Z. In order to see how the Enigma machine is able to do such clever substitutions, we shall now take a closer look at its components. The electrical circuits of the machine are shouted in a set of three rotors. When a button is pressed, say the U button, the circuits will encode it and give an output G. During this process, the rotor turns once and changes the electrical connection. If the U button is pressed again, it will give a different output T instead. It is possible to substitute the same letter with different letters because each time the rotor rotates, the entire coding system of the Enigma machine changes. Each rotor turns 26 times before making one rotation. Upon completion of a rotation, the first rotor will cause the second rotor to turn once. Similarly, after the second rotor makes one rotation, it will cause the third rotor to turn once. Doing a little bit of math, this meant that the rotors could give 26 cubed possible combinations. But that's not all. In addition to that, at the front of the machine there is a plug board, where the electrical signals could be rewired manually. Wires could be used to connect any two alphabets into a pair. Alphabets that formed the pair will be swapped over. This meant that if A and B were connected together, B becomes A and A becomes B. Imagine if you connected multiple pairs of alphabets together. Yes, this feature would create billions of additional possibilities to the Enigma machine's combinations. In order to decrypt these messages, the receiver would have to refer to a codebook. This codebook will tell them how they should set the three rotors and how to connect the wires in the plug board for a particular day of the month. After learning about how the Enigma machine works, you must be wondering whether this ingenious code was ever broken. Well, it was, eventually by a British genius named Alan Turing.